Welcome to Carver Hawkeye Arena in Iowa City. The 20th ranked Spartans and the Iowa Hawkeyes do battle, both trying to go to 2-0 in the Big Ten Conference. Larry Morgan and former South Carolina head basketball coach Eddie Fogler. Carver Hawkeye Arena the side as Steve Alford and Tom Izzo get ready to do battle. It's been an interesting series between these two teams, and certainly both teams rely, Eddie, on outside scoring for their leading scorer. Talking about a couple of outstanding young perimeter players in Chris Hill and Chauncey Leslie.
Well, what I like best, Larry, about Chris Hill and Chauncey Leslie is they were part-time starters last year, and now with Marcus Taylor leaving and Luke Recker for Iowa, they are the man that these teams go to now. They're the leading scorers for both teams. They play the most minutes for both teams, and they both can shoot the ball, although we know Hill is a great three-point shooter and Leslie is a slasher.
Let's take a look at the starting lineups. Michigan State's had so many injuries. Tom Izzo has already used five different starting combinations. There's who he will start today. The Hawkeyes have been blessed with good health. Steve Alford has not made any alterations in his starting lineup in any game this year.
Well, Iowa must stay out of foul trouble. Iowa only plays seven players during a basketball game. Michigan State can go 11 deep. Foul trouble is huge here today. And again, Michigan State will try to get the Hawkeyes in foul trouble.
The officials today, Gene Mongey, Steve Stiles, and Tim Hutchinson, and we are ready for action. Aloysius Anyagonye getting ready for Michigan State, jumping center opposite Jared Reiner, and the opening tap controlled by Iowa. Jeff Horner has really played good basketball the last three, a freshman out of Mason City with the ball.
Can you hear me?
Now Glenn Worley with it. This is Reiner. The Hawkeyes will look for some patience and long possession today as Horner knocks down the three.
Well, excellent start for the Hawkeyes. Horner knocks down the three. A very good standstill three-point shooter.
Horner's really playing well his freshman year, and as the competition has gotten tougher, he's gotten better. Here's Chris Hill coming off a four-point game against Ohio State. The Buckeyes decided to stop him. Coming up with the block is another freshman on the floor for Iowa, Greg Bruner. The recovery by yet another freshman, Paul Davis. Davis again in traffic. And Agagne with a tip. And it's going to be war on the boards today, Eddie, as Leslie leads the breakaway. The bump and the foul on Hill.
Well, excellent offensive rebounding possession for the Spartans. They had two, three chances to get it. They couldn't come down with the offensive rebound, and Iowa breaks out and gets to the basket as Leslie goes to the hole.
What we saw at the start of that play is what we will see all day. War on the boards, because it's number one and number two in rebound margin in the Big Ten. Right now, Iowa a shade ahead of Michigan State in that category. The Hawkeyes struggled with free throws at Northwestern on Wednesday night, hitting only 11 of 21. Obviously, they need them today against Michigan State.
And Michigan State was 29 of 30 against Northwestern on the other side of the ledger.
So if it gets to be a free throw contest, you know who that favors. Hill guilty of the double dribble. The Iowa Hawkeyes with a 4-0 lead and the basketball.
Well, surprise press there by Iowa, and Hill turns it over.
Steve Alford says to beat Michigan State, you must have toughness, transition, and board play. And he said, without all three, you'll never beat the Spartans.
Here we see Iowa in motion offense. Quick set plays into motion for Steve Alford.
And always the screens. Worley with a baseline feed to Horner, but it's stripped and taken away by Allen Anderson. Hill for three. That's the 107th three of his career, and he is only in his second season at Michigan State. What a great shooter.
Excellent patience by the Spartans. Hill, a 45% three-point shooter, gets his feet set and knocks it home.
Worley trouble along the baseline, travels, and the ball goes back to the Spartans.
Well, now we'll look at Tom Izzo's offense. Michigan State is a set play basketball team. Almost 95% of their plays will be set plays versus 95% motion offense for Iowa.
And if you don't get the Hill early, as Iowa did in that time, he can alone burn you. Out of the corner, it is Corbett. And the rebound kept alive by Leslie. Iowa out rebounding foes by 6.5 a game, and Michigan State by about the same margin. Bruner for three, and the rebound is taken by Anyagonye. Kelvin Torbert playing better basketball now than he did last year. And of course, the experience has to be a factor there. Davis loses to Worley. Bruner doesn't get the numbers. Leslie trying to take it against Hill. Steve Alford has stretched long possessions today against Michigan State and their outstanding defense.
Wow, great block by Davis, comes across the lane, and Hill also did a great job on Leslie, sliding his feet earlier in that possession. Larry, this tempo is really up and down. If this continues this way, there'll be more possessions in this 40-minute basketball game. It'll be harder for Iowa to stay out of foul trouble.
The ever-animated Tom Izzo, three-time National Coach of the Year. A great record he's compiled at Michigan State, as you see right there. And, of course, won a national championship and three Final Fours. Hill looking for his second three right there. A little bit of daylight. He is deadly. He has already scored more in about 3 minutes than he did against Ohio State on Thursday. And the Spartans have their first lead at 6-4. Horner, the point guard for Iowa, 19 assists, 3 turnovers in the last 3 ball games.
And 2 assists for every turnover overall this season. You want your point guards to always have at least 2 assists for every turnover.
Nice.
There's
pass.
Another assist.
Now that's why Horner's getting so many assists. What a great pass.
Has savvy beyond his years and very good poise for a freshman as well.
Spartans getting the ball down in a hurry. Hill open, looking for his third three. The rebound by Reiner. Jared Reiner, number 2 in the conference in rebounding. Whirly ahead, and Hill fouls it. So Chris Hill, 2 early fouls for Michigan State.
Well, another great pitch ahead on this fast break, and we get to the basket again for Leslie. Horner, excellent look up the court.
And Whirly taking it in deep. Hill coming over for the foul. Great pass right there, Eddie. And stepping to the free throw line, Glenn Whirly, who the other night at Northwestern missed a couple of free throws in the final minute. Whirly, though, normally an outstanding free throw shooter at 79%.
Okay.
And the Hawkeyes have hit 3 of the first 4 from the line, and they go into the lead at 7-6. And a turnover by Michigan State. Tom Izzo telling us last night, Eddie, his ball club turning it over way more than he'd like to see.
Careless decision up the court. The Spartans are playing a little too fast. Another unforced turnover.
They are averaging 16 turnovers, and so are the Hawkeyes. But in the last 3 ball games, Iowa has reduced that number to an average of 10 turnovers per game. Release sees the opening, and Agagne tips it away. Whirly recovers. And it's 6 early points for Glenn Whirly and a 10-6 early lead for Iowa. Nagagne battles Bruner and Reiner. And Reiner has his 21st block. Leslie from behind, fouled by Anderson. Chauncey Leslie hits the deck hard, and Allen Anderson had no choice there. You don't want to foul a guy with just a little and have him hit the shot.
Well, excellent speed by Leslie. He is a jet when he gets out in the open court.
And looks like maybe the wrist that he is favoring. So Leslie, Iowa's leading scorer, goes down hard. Tim Hutchinson asking him if he's okay.
Hannah Conway, great offensive rebound, but gets rejected by 2 Hawkeyes. And here we see the speed and quickness to the basket for Leslie as he gets fouled.
And again, he was holding his right wrist as he got up, but Chauncey Leslie to the line, where he's a 77% free throw shooter. Now, the Iowa guards have put in a lot of minutes, both Horner and Leslie averaging 36 minutes a game.
That is very difficult to do, Larry. I never wanted as a basketball coach to have any of my starters go more than 32 minutes if possible in a basketball game.
And Agagne with the rebound, but the takeaway by Jeff Horner for Iowa. Hawkeyes with an early 5-point lead. Leslie through the baseline. Does not get the roll, but he does get the foul. And Leslie will go right back to the line.
How explosive is that young man taking it to the basket? Kind of reminds me of a little Allen Iverson.
Arazem Lorbeck on the foul for Michigan State.
Nice pitch by Whirly to the corner, and he explodes to the basket and almost gets a 3-point opportunity.
Lorbeck coming in at the last dead ball, as did Maurice Ager, an outstanding freshman. Not a good freshman in the Big Ten this year. We're going to see plenty of them today.
Ager's a young man they have high hopes for. He can create his own shot. He's a good 3-point shooter. He's been injured and has missed a lot of practice time.
Adds a new dimension to Michigan State, according to Izzo. The rebound run down by Anagagne. He is Michigan State's leading rebounder. is Anderson, who's going to see more time at the point. He's played four positions at Michigan State, but Connors are looking for a point guard, especially while Rocky Johnson is still on the men. So we're going to see a lot of Anderson at the point during the Big Ten season.
And that is out of position for Anderson, and Hill, in fact, is really not a true point guard as well.
The block by Rollo. And we've got a timeout. The Iowa Hawkeyes playing on their home court, trying to go to 2-0 in the Big Ten, off to a quick start, and they lead the Spartans 12-6.
Today's Big Ten game is brought to you by Volkswagen. Visit VW.com for a dealer near you. And by Sitco. At Sitco, we enjoy basketball as much as you do. Sitco, we know you.
The Iowa Hawkeyes, with an 8-point run, have opened a 12-6 lead. We welcome you back to Iowa City. Barry Morgan, along with the man who's coached a lot of college basketball, the Wichita State, Vanderbilt, and 8 years at South Carolina, Eddie Fogler. Glad to have you with us this afternoon for Big Ten Conference basketball.
Well, a very up-and-down game here the first 4 minutes, and Iowa has been very aggressive on the defensive end, has had three or four block shots already. I've been very impressed with their intensity.
And so the Iowa Hawkeyes and Michigan State, really a good rivalry between teams that split last year. Michigan State won the final meeting of the regular season, 93-79, after losing at Iowa City last January, 75-71. The early shooting in the ball game, you mentioned, it's been an up-and-down pace. The Iowa Hawkeyes have been blistering the Nets. Michigan State possession following the timeout. Hill on the miss. Now 2 out of 4, all for the threes. The ball out of bounds off the green. So it's Iowa basketball.
Well, Iowa has been able to challenge Hill's last two shots outside, and neither one went down.
Iowa trying to add to an 8-0 run. The Hawkeyes 9-3 overall. The Spartans 9-4, ranked 20th in the country. Leslie against Hager. There's a good matchup of quick athletic players. Reiner in deep. The crash for the rebounds, and the ball knocked out of bounds. And it's the last touch by Allen Anderson. It's going to be war into the boards. No place for the faint of heart.
Absolutely not. Here we'll see Michigan State zone on all out-of-bounds underneath plays. I agree totally with Tom Izzo. I think it's much more difficult to get a good shot versus zone out-of-bounds under the basket than man-to-man.
Worley looking for a three out of the corner. And Worley is on fire to start the ball game. He has scored 9 of Iowa's first 15 points. The Hawkeyes extend the run now to 11-0 with this three by Glenn Worley.
Well, Worley not noted for his three-point shots, but Chauncey gets the ball over to him. He gets a wide open three, and he knocks it home. Nice play by Leslie to move the ball quickly.
At the other end, Greg Bruner with the first foul for Iowa, sending Allen Anderson to the line, coming off a career-best 18 against Ohio State, including 14 of 14 from the free throw line. Whoops. There goes that string.
Well, you jinxed him, Larry. What do you think?
I don't believe that. I don't believe in that jinx. But Anderson couldn't miss the other night, and neither could the Spartans for the most part. As you said, they hit their first 26. Wind up with 29 out of 30. And they are an outstanding free throw shooting team.
75% at the line. They were fifth in the nation last year at over 77%.
And that ends the 11-0 Iowa run. Leslie off the baseline. The rebound comes to Hill. And he will push it ahead for the Spartans. The streaking Ager on the slam. What an athletic player he is. Ager with his first basket. And it's a 15-9 ball game. And now the Spartans with back-to-back baskets. Worley against the double team shoots and scores. There's no stopping Glenn Worley right now. 11 points so far.
Inside, outside for Worley.
Lorbeck finds Anderson. Anderson against Bruner. And Ballinger's coming to the lineup. There's Lorbeck having it blocked. Horner pushing it ahead for the Hawkeyes. They want to get the ball in Worley's hands. So far, he's been unstoppable. Ballinger trying to stop him. Horner coming off the screen by Worley. In the lane goes Reiner. Lorbeck with the rebound. And here comes Ager for Michigan State. Reese Ager, Eddie, what kind of potential does he bring to Michigan State?
Well, Ager brings the potential of being able to make the basket off the dribble and also can shoot the ball well for three.
He's a freshman from Crockett High in Detroit, been plagued by injuries in his freshman year. Missed 6 games with a stress fracture, then had some fainting spells, missed another couple of games, but when he can get some practice, he's going to be tremendous. Wurlick slices in deep, gets the foul, and gets the basket as well. And nice. Worley has 13 for Iowa.
Nice pump fake. Nice pass out. The pump fake gets him up in the air. He drives, avoids the charge, and gets a chance for a three-point play. Glenn Worley can take the ball to the basket, and he has already hit a three. Hard to guard a guy who can go outside and inside.
Hager picking up the foul for Michigan State. Worley coming off a 16-point performance at Northwestern, 13 already. Eclipsing his average, and he is number 2 on the Hawkeyes in scoring, and it's a quick 20-9 advantage for Iowa. Here's Lorbeck in deep and gets the roll.
How about that move by this young freshman? Pump fake, puts it down left-handed and gets it off the glass.
Adam Slovenia could have played pro basketball overseas, but his dad wanted him to come to Michigan State. Hoyer on the drive, scores for the Hawkeyes.
Off the curl cut to his left hand and off the board.
It is a blistering pace, and right now the Hawkeyes are taking advantage of it. Got the turnover that time. Brody Boyd checking into the Iowa lineup, as is Sean Sondeleiter.
Horner off the curl screen, goes to the left side and uses his left hand. Nice play.
Iowa trying to build on an 11-point lead. Best start of the year for the Iowa Hawkeyes.
And this motion offense with all the screening action is making it tough on the Spartans. Aggressive defense.
The clear out for Leslie. And he beats Ager to the spot and scores.
They are lighting it up on the offensive end, the Hawkeyes are.
Iowa guilty of a foul as Michigan State tries to make the ball come down quickly in transition. Sondeleiter guilty of the grab. And Steve Alford loves the start of his Iowa Hawkeyes as they have jumped to a 13-point lead against 20th-ranked Michigan State here in Iowa City.
Back in the Big Ten studios to check on Conference USA, St. Louis and Louisville. Drew Diener warming up from the outside for the Billikens, knocks it down, and right now it's 23-18 St. Louis. Let's go back to Larry and Eddie.
Iowa 24, Michigan State 11. Glenn Worley on fire for Iowa.
Well, he is lighting it up here today. He can do it all, inside and outside. He can shoot the three today. And what he does best, he can take the ball and spin and get it to the basket, inside or outside. Here's a little pump fake on Ballinger. Boom, and he gets to the basket and scores and gets to the line for a three-point opportunity.
Tom Izzo tried to recruit Glenn Worley out of Iowa City, where he's from, but he decided to stay home and go to Iowa. Now Izzo's wishing he'd closed the deal, huh, Eddie?
Absolutely.
Yelan Aganye, Lorbeck, Ager on the floor for Michigan State. And Aganye in the lane, draws the foul against Sondeleiter. And Sean Sondeleiter, too early, Iowa fouls.
Well, early in this game, Iowa's doing a very good job inside, not fouling on the post defense. Here they pick up a foul, and Aganye to the line. I believe Michigan State's going to continue to try to pound the ball inside to get the Hawkeyes in foul problems.
And Aganye averaging 11 points a game over the last three, averaging 8.5 on the year. He's also pulled down 5 rebounds today for Michigan State.
Larry, interesting to note, both these teams have made more free throws during the season than their opponents have attempted. I don't know if I've ever seen two teams play together or against each other where you can say that.
Jared Reiner back in for Iowa as Sondeleiter goes to the bench with 2 fouls. Aganye knocks the next one down for Michigan State. That's a 24-12 Iowa lead. Worley now being guarded by Aganye. Here's Leslie coming through the baseline, taken away by Aganye. Ager is open over Horner.
Wow, nice counter. Good pitch ahead by Hill. Ager just pulls up and knocks down another shot from the right side.
Very animated Tom Izzo at the top of your screen. He rarely sits down during a ball game. Looks like he plays every play. And we know that he's already run 4 or 5 miles today, so he's got plenty of energy.
Well, I saw Tom this morning go out in about 10-degree weather, go for a run. He does play. After the game, he's exhausted.
Those Upper Peninsula guys are pretty tough, aren't they?
Yes.
Hill goes in deep, Now the pitch to Torbert. Slapped away by Wuerle. Torbert on the recovery. Now Hill tries to save it from going over the midcourt line and cannot do it, and it's Iowa ball on the Michigan State turnover.
Another turnover. I know Coach Izzo isn't happy with that.
Steve Alford on the bench for the Iowa Hawkeyes in his fourth year, and today marks his 50th Big Ten game. Just 1-4 against Michigan State. Michigan State, though, of course, has had an amazing run in the last 5 years, best record in the Big Ten. So Steve Alford knows his team in for a challenge this afternoon.
Larry, 27-13 on the road in the last 5 years in the Big Ten, by far the best road team in the Big Ten.
Yeah, that is six more wins than any other team has over the last 5 years. That is amazing. The turnovers, that's what's got to be plaguing Tom Izzo right now. Hawkeyes exhibiting some patience.
Brody Boyan, excellent three-point shooter for the Hawkeyes.
And he's had the hot hand the last two Iowa ball games. Leslie tries to break down the Michigan State defense, and Torbert comes out with it for the Spartans. Stops over Horner and knocks it down. Strikes me, Eddie, there are a lot of Michigan State guys that can score off the dribble.
Well, both Torbert and Ager are good two-point shooters pulling up off the dribble. Neither has great range, Larry. Neither looks for the three, but they can get into the lane, pull up, and make shots. Hill on the other side of it is the Spartans' three-point shooter.
With Michigan State on a run, Steve Alford calling a 30-second timeout. So let's us take a moment to thank our Big Ten corporate sponsor, Cooper Tire. Proud to be the official tire of the Big Ten Conference. Cooper Tires, don't give up a thing.
You know, we look at Steve Alford, a coach's son, played in the NBA, a gold medal winner for the United States, an NCAA championship at Indiana, born and bred to coach and play the game of basketball.
Special day for his dad, which we'll tell you about a little bit later on today.
Back go many years ago when I was an assistant at North Carolina, Sam and Steve came by to visit the University of North Carolina, Chapel Hill. I think Steve was an eighth grader and a skinny guy at that back then.
And there is Sam Alford. This is the 1,000th game on the bench for him today in his career. Junior high, high school, and now college as an assistant or former assistant, now director of basketball operations at Iowa for his son, Steve. Iowa trying to make something happen with no doubt a called play out of the timeout.
One of the few set plays they will run.
But in the way to steal is Allen Anderson. Looks behind him for Brody Boyd. And Boyd forces the turnover. Now, did Anderson make a mistake by looking behind him there, Eddie?
Well, he did make a mistake. He was trying to find the defense. He should have just taken it and rammed it home. He's an outstanding athlete, and give Boyd credit for great hands. Reiner turns it over, and Anderson checks where he's at, and he slaps the ball away, and the ball goes to Iowa.
And you would have wanted him to just take it strong. That's probably what Tom Izzo was thinking. Working against Hill.
Michigan State has excellent size up front, but their guards are very tall as well as they challenge Boyd's shot.
Anderson with the rebound of the Boyd miss. Spartans giving up 62 points a game. Iowa giving up 61, so every possession hotly contested. Glad to have you with us this afternoon in Iowa City at Carver Hawkeye Arena. This building 20 years old this month. In fact, Michigan State was the first opponent, and they are the opponent this afternoon. I'm Larry Morgan, along with former South Carolina coach Eddie Fogler. Glad to have you with us for Big Ten basketball. Both these teams have won their first conference games. The Hawkeyes getting into the paint early, and you might have expected the converse to be true.
Well, I did, Larry, and Iowa's doing an excellent job getting the ball inside and scoring. Michigan State has had a number of shots blocked.
Inside 9 minutes in the first half. Wuerle has been guarded by a number of Spartans as they've tried to cool him off, and coming up with the interception is Kemba Brackett. You already see how many players Tom Izzo has come off his bench with, and Steve Alford, on the other hand, has a rotation of basically seven. Hill on the miss, Bruner with the rebound.
Iowa doing a very good job on the defensive board. Michigan State not getting many second opportunities.
Izzo's already played nine players, and the Hawkeyes again with seven, but Sondelier two fouls, so now the rotation becomes even shorter, at least for the rest of the half.
Well, Iowa's played very aggressively, but they stay out of foul trouble for the most part.
And there is an off-the-ball foul called against Michigan State. I believe they got Anagonye, and they did. Aloysius Anagonye picks up his first foul.
And that is the seventh on the Spartans. Iowa will go to the line for a 1-1.
Iowa, 71% free throw shooting team on the year, and Glenn Worley, Jared Reiner, both outstanding free throw shooters. It's Worley on the line now as Alan Anderson replaces Chris Hill. Worley with 14 early points for Iowa, his season high 20 against Tennessee State in December.
I asked Steve Alford yesterday at practice how he planned to get around his depth problem. Only seven players. He has conditioned his team, Larry, to play in four-minute segments. Four-minute game, you have a TV break. A four-minute game, we have a TV break. They've done an excellent job of playing consecutive back-to-back four-minute games here.
Glenn Worley with a 16-point first half has led the Iowa Hawkeyes to a 10-point lead over the 20th-ranked Michigan State Spartans here in Iowa City. Back to Iowa City, where the Iowa Hawkeyes have a 10-point lead over the 20th-ranked Michigan State Spartans. Iowa doing a good job shooting the basketball and getting some points in the paint.
Absolutely, and have been far more effective with their aggressive style of play. They've scored inside, outside. They've caused turnovers by Michigan State, yet Michigan State has played better here, Larry, in the last few minutes. Down 10 with 8 minutes to go. They want to chip away at this lead and see if they can cut this down to 2 of 4 at halftime.
Only three Hawkeyes have scored, but Glenn Worley with 16 points leading Iowa. Now, coming up following this ball game at 4:30 Eastern, 3:30 Central, should be a real good matchup. The explosive Wisconsin Badgers with an outstanding young player you saw right there. And Alonzo Tucker against Illinois, the Fighting Illini, led by the Big Ten's leading scorer, Brian Cook. That's this afternoon following this one, Wisconsin-Illinois. Don't want to miss that one, only from ESPN Plus. Brian Cook, he is the Big Chief, leading the Big Ten in scoring.
Well, I think the best player in the Big Ten. He can stand outside and shoot threes. He's got long arms inside to score, can block shots, an outstanding basketball player.
And of course, Sean Harrington was red hot from the perimeter the other night. D. Brown, an outstanding freshman. They got a lot to be excited about at Champaign, where the Illini ranked 11th in the country.
And Iowa comes out going zone, matchup zone, trying to find a man on the ball each time the perimeter player catches it.
Anderson missing over the zone, and Gagne runs down the rebound and nearly runs down a teammate.
With Hill out of the game, this is an excellent move by Steve Alford to go zone. The Spartans really don't have a very good three-point shooter on the court.
And again, Anderson will run the point. Out of the corner, it is Kelton Torbert knocking it down.
Interestingly to note again, Torbert can shoot the ball, but not from three. He's generally a 17-foot jump shooter.
Comes in averaging 9 points a ball game, scored double figures both times against Iowa last year, so he has played well against the Hawkeyes. Calling for it was Reiner, but knocking it away is Davis. The shot clock is at 10, and off the ball, violation is spotted, and the Hawkeyes are guilty of an offensive foul.
Back screen by Worley. He did not give the defender time and distance to get over the back screen. Foul.
That is Iowa's 15th foul, while Michigan State has committed 7. Chauncey Leslie now takes the seat. Jeff Horner back into the Iowa lineup.
When you set a back screen, you must give the defender enough time and distance to get over the back screen.
Anderson, Davis, and Agagne, Ager, and Torbert on the floor for Michigan State. And Davis has trouble inside, and the turnover puts it back in Iowa's hands. And right now, a change in the Michigan State lineup. Erasm Lorbeck comes back into the ballgame, the 6'10 freshman out of Slovenia.
Well, with Davis and Lorbeck, certainly Coach Tom Izzo has two outstanding young big people for the future. However, he does not play them together very much. He does not want the two freshmen on the court at the same time, particularly on the road.
And he's still trying to get Adam Ballinger untracked, and he's another big guy at 6'9".
Nice patience by Iowa in their motion offense, spreading the court, setting a lot of screens.
Gruner finds Worley, a quick pass to Reiner. The shot clock is at 10. Michigan State, some outstanding defense on this Iowa possession. Open is Worley with 3 on the shot clock.
Wow, that's a backbreaker. The Spartans play excellent defense for 32 seconds, but can't sustain it, and Iowa scores.
And it's an 18-point first half for Worley. Iowa guilty of the foul. Let's take a look at the way Iowa moved the ball.
Well, first of all, it's great effort to get the ball back for Iowa, and they just continue to pass the ball, and Worley knocks it down with 3 seconds on the 35-second shot clock. Excellent play and patience.
Jared Reiner picks up his second foul for Iowa, and again, the Hawkeyes with two players with two fouls early, and when you only have a seven-player rotation, it's pretty difficult. Something Steve Alford has to be worried about is Chris Hill will inbound for Tom Izzo's team.
And Michigan State should continue to go inside. Sondra Leiter now is the center for the Iowa Hawkeyes.
Hager over him to score. Maurice Hager, red hot, 6 points off the bench for Michigan State.
You can see why the Michigan State staff is so high on that young man.
Corner finds Sondra Leiter. Sondra Leiter got in too deep, and Lorbeck was able to deny him the shot, and the rebound is taken out of there by Chris Hill. Hill behind the Anagonye screen. That's like getting a screen by a building, isn't it?
And that's a big shot as the Spartans chip away and get back into this basketball game.
Who's going to get around an Anagonye pick?
Somebody in the NFL.
Maybe.
I think we'll see Coach Alford come back with one of the two big guys before this half is over because the lead is dwindling.
Hill with three threes for Michigan State. Boyd answers with a three for Iowa. So the Hawkeyes build their lead back to eight as we go inside 5 minutes in the first half. And it's hit by Morbin. Morbin with his second half.
Excellent touch by a 6'10 freshman.
Typical of a lot of European players, he has that good mid-range shot.
Michigan State is switching all screens on the perimeter among the perimeter players, trying to guard the Iowa Hawkeyes players coming off the screens in their motion offense.
Anderson and Ballinger come in for Michigan State, and Leslie comes in for Iowa. Now Bogracus is also about to come in for the Spartans.
With this lineup on the court for the Hawkeyes, they have three true guards.
It must be tough when you're trying to defend Michigan State because they change their personnel so frequently.
Well, fatigue is part of the game, not only foul trouble, but fatigue, and Michigan State looks like the fresher team at this point.
Pointer looking for three. Hager with a rebound. Anderson pushes it ahead for the Spartans. All the way, challenged by Sondra Leiter, and a foul called in Iowa. For the Hawkeyes, Brody Boyd picks up his first foul, and that is Iowa's seventh.
Michigan State is doing an excellent job pushing the ball on defensive rebounds. They have a number of times in this game have pitched the ball up the court and have been able to get to the basket before Iowa has gotten back with their transition defense.
Erazem Lorbeck at the line. A very interesting player from Slovenia. As he misses the first, let's go to Mike Gleason in the Big Ten studio.
Well, we're coming up at halftime. We'll recap that Purdue Northwestern ball game. The number five UConn goes into overtime against Miami. And we'll hear the latest from the University of Iowa. I'll come up at halftime in a few short minutes, Larry.
Thanks, Mike. Lorbeck knocks the second one down. Michigan State trailed the one time by 12. They've now cut the Iowa lead down to five. Leslie against Bogracus, inside Sondra Leiter against Lorbeck. Lorbeck gets the block, and Ballinger gets the rebound. Ballinger having some trouble with Worley. Horner comes up with it.
Great effort by both teams. It's fun to watch this kind of effort in a basketball game.
Isn't it incredible? That intensity? Typical Big Ten game, really typical of this rivalry.
Jeff Horner committed to Steve Alford as a freshman. I said, Steve, a freshman. He said, Eddie, we knew he was going to be that good. He quarterbacked the football team. He's our toughest player.
Out of the same high school as Dean Oliver, Mason City High School. Jeff played for his dad. Bob Horner still the coach there. Ballinger looking for three, but followed by Lorbeck, not there the first time. Gets his own rebound and gets fouled. Lorbeck, an interesting player, Eddie, in that his dad's the general manager of the Slovenian national team that he played for. Could have stayed in Europe and played for a six-figure salary, but his dad said, I'd like to go see him in the NBA someday, and to do that, it's important that he gets some experience under a guy like Tom Izzo.
Well, you see a number of foreign players who have NBA aspirations coming over to play college ball instead of getting paid to play in Europe.
Now let's take a moment to thank our Big Ten corporate sponsor, WorldSpan, official travel distribution and technology provider of the Big Ten Conference.
That is either the third or fourth foul that Iowa has picked up when the Spartans have been able to get an offensive rebound for a second attempt.
And Last foul, by the way, on Hoyter, and it's his second, so we have a timeout on the court. 3:21 left in the first half. Tom Izzo has seen his team come back from a slow start. Michigan State trailed early by 13. Now Iowa leads it 31-27. Now let's take a look at the Volkswagen game summary.
We can see the field goal percentage. Iowa shooting the ball very well, but getting out rebounded. And Michigan State's depth is really becoming a factor. Iowa looks more fatigued, and the foul trouble has kept some of their better players on the bench. And Michigan State has chipped away and gotten back into this basketball game with 3:21 to go.
And you see Glenn Worley, 18 points, his career best is 20, and so against the team that recruited him, Michigan State, Worley having a career half.
Well, Michigan State has 17 rebounds, Iowa only 10.
And early in the game, that was an even stack. Leslie on the miss, Corbett runs down the rebound, Michigan State has the numbers. Hager on the miss, Lorbeck has the ball almost taken away from him by Boyd. And it's out of bounds off Lorbeck. It's Iowa basketball.
Well, give Brody Boyd credit. The 6'10 youngster for Michigan State. Lorbeck had it, but Boyd wrestled it away, and Iowa comes up with the possession.
Horner, Worley, Boyd, Reiner, and Leslie on the floor right now for Iowa.
Three true guards going against big perimeter guards for Michigan State. Taller players.
You're guarding corner. Iowa guilty of a foul inside off the ball, and the ball goes back to Michigan State. Reiner with the foul, his third.
Larry, here's a rule change. That is called team possession offensive basketball. That should be, in the past, a one-and-one, but with the rule change, any team possession off-the-ball foul is no longer a shooting foul. Michigan State gets possession, but they do not go to the foul line. That is a rule change for the season.
Good catch on your part. You're right up on those rules. Jared Reiner with three fouls on the Iowa bench. Sean Sondeleiter, his backup, with two fouls back into the game. So Steve Alford sending his big bodies against the number of Michigan State big bodies has some problems.
Well, Coach Alford gambled to get Reiner back in the game, and the gamble failed.
Leslie with the foul, and that's his first foul. The Hawkeyes have now put Michigan State in the double bonus.
Well, we said at the outset, foul trouble would be a big part of this game. Iowa, the first 5 minutes, played aggressively without fouling. However, the last 15 minutes or so, they've encountered a number of fouls and foul problems.
Maurice Ager to the line, 11 of 13 on the season from the free throw line. 6 points this afternoon off the bench. Ager, Tom Izzo's first Detroit Public School League recruit. And Izzo says he really adds a new dimension to Michigan State when he's able to play.
Well, he can go get a basket with the graduation or Marcus Taylor leaving early to go to professional basketball. They lack a guy who can go get a basket. This young man looks like he can do that. In fact, he's only had one-third of the practices under his belt. He looks much more comfortable than someone who's missed all that practice time.
And Iowa's 13-point lead shaved to three by the Ager free throws. Iowa dominated the first 10 minutes, Eddie, but now Michigan State is dominating. Rebound Bruner. Basket Bruner.
Offensive rebounding can cure a lot of problems. Iowa not shooting the ball well here lately, but Bruner comes up with the offensive rebound and scores.
And Bruner, one of the best offensive rebounders in the Big Ten. And we'll talk about the offensive rebounding ability of Bruner and take another look at it.
Well, the size of Michigan State bothering the shot by Sunderlider, but Bruner wrestles the ball away and makes a little short jump shot on the offensive rebound. Nice play.
And Aganye on the offensive foul. The Iowa Hawkeyes get it back with 1:51 to go in the first half. Ballinger back into the lineup for Michigan State.
And I believe that's Anagonwe's third foul, but that really doesn't affect Michigan State very much. They just bring in another big body. They're very deep at the 4 and 5 positions.
His second foul, actually.
Excuse me.
But nevertheless, Tom Izzo not wanting him to get number three. And Aganye on the bench for the final minute 45 of the first half. Worley finds Sondeleiter.
Worley penetrated into the lane and makes an excellent pass to Sondeleiter for a layup.
And Worley with a deflection on the defensive end of the court. Worley stepping up big for the Hawkeyes. This time he gets the penetration.
Penetrate, look away past us on the ladder as he throws the defense. He freezes the defense and dumps it across. Easy basket.
Bograkis, Hill, Ballinger, Hager, and Lorbeck on the floor for Michigan State.
Worley guarding a 6'10 player in the post in Lorbeck.
Leslie goes for the takeaway and gets it. And a terrific play by Ager, and then goaltending will give Bruner the basket.
Nice play by Bruner. Most people here would have stopped running because they thought Leslie had a dead layup. Leslie shows that football speed and quickness, and he gets it pinned by Ager, but Bruner never gave up and laid it in the basket.
That's one of the things the Iowa coaches really like about this freshman from Charles City, Iowa. He never stops. He hustles all the time. And Michigan State will use a timeout with 1:03 left to play in the first half. Now coming up at halftime with Mike Leeson in the Big Ten studio, we'll have a recap on the earlier game today, Northwestern traveling to Purdue. Then take a look at a Husky thriller and also the Mopeat recap. And in that Husky thriller, UConn coming up with a big victory. That's all coming up with Mike Leeson in the Big Ten studio at halftime.
Well, that leaves UConn and Duke as the only two undefeated teams, I think. Well, Wake Forest would be a third, I believe, undefeated in college basketball.
Today in Iowa City, it's been quite a battle with great intensity between Iowa and Michigan State.
Excellent intensity. The effort going after loose balls has been incredible. Every possession here is played like it is the last possession of the game. Excellent spurt here the last 2 minutes by Iowa, even with foul trouble.
Tom Izzo giving us some of his keys last night, and he said containing Chauncey Leslie was one. So far, so good on that score. Taking care of the basketball, he would not give that category a passing grade. Here's Ager rising up and missing the shot. Bograkis with an offensive rebound. A moment ago, Iowa's one-time 13-point lead shaved to three, but now the Hawkeyes have rallied. Anderson tries to cut the lead and does.
Well, you can see Allen Anderson would not take the three-point shot, but he can put it inside the arc and knock down jump shots from 15 feet.
About a five-second differential between the shot clock and the first half clock. So Michigan State should get another possession.
Actually, Larry, UConn was beat at Oklahoma, so they're not undefeated. Let me correct that.
Shot clock is inside 10. Leslie gets around Ager to score.
Well, the little six-foot guard plays bigger than that. He gets to the basket, and Michigan State looking to take a timeout here. Officials just rehandling the basketball. 8 seconds, they got to push it to the basket. Allen Anderson will take this ball to the basket to score or to pitch. And Iowa in a zone for the last 8 seconds.
Anderson almost loses it and does. Boyd couldn't find it, though Bograkis picks it up. Desperation shot not there. And a well-played and intensely played first half comes to an end in Iowa City. Time at Carver Hawkeye Arena. Iowa trying to knock off the 20th ranked Spartans. The Hawkeyes have the lead of the break, 39-30. Now let's go to the Big Ten studio and Mike Leeson. About to start the second half, Iowa 39, Michigan State 30. The Hawkeyes getting big performances from Chauncey Leslie and Glenn Worley.
Well, Leslie and Worley have scored 25 of the 39 Iowa Hawkeye points. They are 8 of 13 from the field combined. The Hawkeyes, Larry, have taken 11 free throws. Those two young men have taken all 11. They are dominating the offensive play for Iowa.
And for that reason, the Hawkeyes led by as many as 13 in the first half and take a 9-point lead into the start of the second half in this 99th meeting between Iowa and Michigan State. The Spartans have won 9 of the last 10, but last year, Iowa beat Michigan State here in Iowa City.
Let's look for a quick set play by Tom Izzo coming to start the second half.
Both teams are back to their starting lineups. By the way, Jared Reiner listed on the scoreboard with 3 fouls, but in fact has just 2 according to the official stat sheet. So Reiner with 2 fouls for the Hawkeyes, Sondelider with 2, and for Michigan State, Hill with 2, and Anna Gagne with 2 as the second half begins.
Well, the Spartans get the shot they want by Tarbert off the set play, but he cannot make the jump shot outside. Time out.
see if Michigan State will make a greater effort at keeping Iowa out of the paint. They made the effort in the first half, but the Hawkeyes showed some patience. Worley trying to get inside now and has it blocked by Enegonye.
That 1-3 that Worley hit early in the game has created a problem for Michigan State. They are now rushing out on him in the perimeter. He's beginning to pump fake and try to beat him off the dribble.
9 seconds on the shot clock for Iowa after the block. Reiner against the shorter Torbert, looks for Bruner, and the way was Davis, and it's picked off by Hill. Hill pulls up. Reiner rebounds. Jared Reiner second in the Big Ten in rebounding, just his third rebound today. Bruner on the spin and the miss, and Enegonye with the rebound. That is his seventh rebound.
Two possessions for Iowa, two block shots for Michigan State.
Anderson finding Davis. This is Hill for three. Hit three of those in the first half. Has missed his first two shots here in the second half. And no one scored in the first 1 minute plus of the first second half.
Paul Davis needs to turn and score when he gets the ball at the low post. No need to kick that outside to Hill.
And Enegonye picks up his third foul for Michigan State. First player on either squad with more than two.
Well, it'll be very important for Iowa to stay out of foul trouble early in the second half. They can't afford to have anybody in foul trouble if they're going to win this game.
It's been 2 years since Iowa knocked off a rated opponent on their home court. They beat then seventh-ranked Illinois back in 2001 in January, and that was their last win over a rated team here in Iowa City.
Well, Davis on Worley's a tough matchup for Davis. Worley's looking to drive Davis from the perimeter any chance he gets.
Leslie takes it with three on the shot clock. Nobody scored yet to begin the second half.
You can see Iowa laying off Enegonye on the perimeter. He's not a shooter.
A little miscommunication between Anderson and Davis and the turnover, which for Michigan State is their 13th. And again, they're averaging on the season 16. Gives it back to Iowa.
Now, Paul Davis has that non-confident look of a freshman on the road in the Big Ten. Coach Izzo sees that. He's going to pull him out and visit with him. And Lorbeck's back in.
Lorbeck, a good first half for Michigan State. 6 points off the bench and four rebounds. So 2:12 into the second half. Neither team has scored. The clear out for Horner. And a push spotted on, I believe, Reiner across the top. And it was. Now Reiner does have his third.
Well, Reiner came to set the ball screen for Horner, who asked for it. He gets called for the illegal block and a foul.
And so Steve Alford goes to his bench and summons Sean Sondelider next time the ball is dead. Meanwhile, now 2.5 into the second half. Both teams still looking for their first points. Hill trying to change that right now and does with his fourth three of the ball game.
Nice set play as Hill sets a lateral screen and gets a down screen for the wide open three.
The Hawkeyes answer, again taking it in deep, and Chauncey Leslie with his 9th point. Anderson slices in to score.
Nice pass by Hill, not to force the jump shot, and Anderson takes it to the glass.
I have to think the quick pace of this ball game favors Michigan State. It's the pace they want to play this game at. Burley trying to break down Lorem, Lorbeck. And the rebound is taken by Lorbeck. Long feet, great catch by Torbert. I'm not sure he ever caught up to that one.
An excellent pitch ahead by Anderson. Nice play by the Spartans.
And it's a 4-point game at 41-37. Iowa's 9-point halftime lead, sliced to 4. Both coaches will make a pair of substitutions next time the ball is dead.
You can see how well Michigan State guards the ball. I don't care what kind of defense you play, man or zone, you must guard the basketball one-on-one.
They've really ratcheted up their defense in this half. Bruner in deep. Reiner, offensive rebound. Reiner has the ball knocked away from him, and a foul is spotted. On Michigan State, they got Anderson. Anderson with his 2nd foul. We have a timeout with 15:57 left to play in regulation. Michigan State able to be aggressive underneath, score off transition, and they have set a 9-point halftime deficit to 4. Michigan State 41-37. Eddie Fogler, tell us how Crisil got this basket.
Sometimes the most open man in basketball is the screener. You're going to see Hill set a lateral screen under the basket for Anagagne, and Lorbeck set a down screen for Hill, who just set a screen. He's wide open and he bangs home the three. Nice screening action. Screen for the screener.
Screen for the screener pays off in a three for Chris Hill, his fourth three of this ballgame. And it has brought the Spartans to within 4 on the road in Iowa City. No team has been more successful in this building as far as a visitor than Michigan State. They've won 9 times in the 20-year history of this building. And on the inbounds, a foul is spotted.
When you look at Michigan State, out of bounds underneath defense, this sort of looks like a man-to-man, but they are in a zone. They play a matchup zone on every possession out of bounds underneath when they're on the defensive end of the court.
Lorbeck with his second foul. We're checking out some of the other games being played around college basketball today. Bottom of your screen. Busy day in college hoops. Horner for 3.
You better get out on Horner. The Spartans lucky. He had a good look. Feet were set, but hit the back rim.
And remember, Wisconsin at number 11, Illinois immediately following this telecast. Adrian on the miss, Torbert on the follow.
Wow, how about that thunder dunk? Great offensive rebound, and he smashes it home.
And it's suddenly a 2-point ball game. It was a 9-point Iowa lead at halftime, but the Spartans have caught fire to begin the second half.
Michigan State's wings are awfully big. They're excellent offensive rebounders, and they're very big guards.
Roy looking for Sondeleiter, who may not have been looking for the pass. Picked off by Hill. Sondeleiter at the other end recovers.
Rhody Boyd tipping it away from behind.
Here is Worley. Is he still hot? Yes. And it is a new career high, 21 for Glenn Worley.
But Horner made that play, Larry. He penetrated into the lane and kicked it to the wide open Worley. Another assist for Jeff Horner.
Now Ballinger spots up. Adam Ballinger, who's really struggled in his senior year. Last year, third team all-conference, though hurt. This year, healthy but struggling.
That's a big basket. That young man gives Michigan State a fourth person on the court who can shoot the basketball when he's playing with confidence.
And if that starts a string for him, then Tom Izzo's grinning from ear to ear, because that's a missing piece of the puzzle right now.
Tough matchup for Lorbeck to play Worley. Worley has got 2 threes, but he's a better driver. And he's inside out today, hard to guard.
Worley still looking for 3. Boom! He hits another. And it is a 24-point game for Glenn Worley.
Well, if I'm Coach Izzo, I'm looking to change the matchup. I don't think Lorbeck can play Worley.
Lorbeck finds Ballinger, and Ballinger off the bench for 2 in a row for Michigan State.
Well, the big man just gave up 3, but he got back 2 with an easy pass. Coach Izzo will tell him he's minus 1.
Yes, he will. Worley with a feed on the baseline to Boyd. Glenn Worley is having the game of his Iowa career.
Unbelievable, but also another nice feed by Boyd. He's getting some good looks and some easy passes from teammates.
Hill guarded by Leslie. Lorbeck missing the 3. Rebound run down by Sondeleiter.
Not the shot Coach Izzo wants.
Leslie on the miss, and Adrian Ballinger combined on the rebound from Michigan State. For the Spartans, first of 3 in a row on the road at Purdue Tuesday, Minnesota on Saturday. So a tough stretch for Tom Izzo's team. They play Thursday, they play again on Tuesday. That's 3 games in 6 days.
And factor in a very tough non-conference schedule, as Tom Izzo always plays at Michigan State.
Boyd falls down. Inside 10 seconds on the shot clock. Shot clock at 4. Ballinger makes a move. Misses the shot. Worley was all over him defensively. Warner pulls it down for Iowa. Up front, Sondeleiter.
Well, Michigan State misses an easy basket, and they do not get back in transition. Both these teams are running the ball out on amazing misses. You must get back and pick up.
And Tom Izzo will use a timeout. 12 12, 16 left to play in regulation. The Hawkeyes have bent, allowed Michigan State to come within three, but they have not broken. And here, running the court well, Sean Sondelider on a big finish. Michigan State, 51-43. Glenn Worley, 24 points, Eddie.
He is lighting it up. First of all, he's scored, but he's also made some excellent passes. This one hand bounce pass to Brody Boyd, going to the basket for an easy, easy layup. And then we've all heard pick and roll. There's a pick and a flare. A flare of four men out who can shoot the three. He's shooting the three well again tonight.
And speaking of shooting, Shooting the Rock is brought to you by Rolling Rock Beer. Grab a rock and look at this shooting by Iowa.
Well, they have shot the ball very well today. Michigan State has taken 13 threes. Larry, they only take 12 a game. They actually have taken one more, but Iowa has shot the ball much better on their home court, and that is usually the case.
Sondelider with the tip, the recovery by Anagagne. Iowa on the season 32% behind the three-point line, but today, a different story. Bogracus, Ager, Ballinger, and Anagagne and Anderson on the floor for Michigan State. Ager over Leslie, gets the roll. Maurice Ager, 9 off the bench. Coming off a 15-point effort against Ohio State, this young man is hot.
He is hot, and he can beat you off the dribble and has the athleticism to jump up in the lane and make shots.
Leslie in deep. Scores.
And Ballinger might have got a piece of that ball, but it still went in the hole.
Steve Alford did not like the way Leslie played in the first half at Northwestern. Thought he was tentative. There is nothing tentative about Leslie today.
Well, he can get it to the rack. He seems to me that he likes to go right. I'd start to push him to his left hand.
Anderson looking for Ballinger. Shot clock's at 10. Ager stops, pops, and scores again.
Wow. Convinced, Larry, you convinced.
I'm sold.
I think that young man can jump up and make baskets. Only a freshman.
He's really quite a story. And again, he's only practiced about a third of the time for Michigan State because of a stress fracture and then sidelined with some fainting spells.
Here we are. We've played 9 minutes in the second half. Iowa has only one team foul. That bodes well for the Hawkeyes. They have stayed out of foul trouble, and they will keep Michigan State off the line.
And with the foul on Ager, we've got a timeout with 11:01 left to play in regulation. It's Iowa by 6. It's Iowa 53, Michigan State 47. The Spartans, of course, have had a tremendous run in the last 5 years.
Well, what Tom Izzo, Larry, has accomplished in Michigan State in the last 5 years, an NCAA championship, 4 regular season Big Ten championships, 2 Big Ten tournament championships. 3 Final Fours, incredible. And I look across the way as an ex-coach, and here we see a great coach sweating it out on the road trying to get a win in the Big Ten. What a profession, Larry, college basketball coaching. I'm glad I'm sitting here with you today.
Absolutely. It is a tough way to make a living, and nobody does it any better than that man, Tom Izzo. Like Michigan State, the last 5 years, 65-16 in the Big Ten. Unbelievable. Inside 11 minutes as they try to get the ball inside to Sondelet. And Anagagne gets a hand on it. We're in Iowa City today for Big Ten basketball at Carver Hawkeye Arena. Larry Morgan and former South Carolina coach Eddie Fogler, glad that you've joined us this afternoon for what's been quite a battle. Michigan State's had just one lead. That was 6-4, 3 minutes into the ballgame. Iowa has led by as many as 13. The Spartans have drawn within 3, but can draw no closer, and right now they trail by 6.
Well, every time Michigan State has made a run, Iowa has answered.
Boyd off the baseline on the miss, and securing the rebound is Jason Andreas, who's into the ballgame for the first time. He's the 10th player that Tom Izzo has used in this game.
And another big body. They are so deep in their 4 and 5 positions.
And there's still Adam Wolf at 6'9 on the bench. He doesn't play as much coming off the hamstring injury, but he's still available.
Well, there was the screen, the screener play that worked so successfully last time, but it was deflected out of bounds. They're giving it to Michigan State.
Officials doing some nice communicating to determine what had been seen and what had occurred.
And here's a place where Michigan State loves to run a set play. Going to try to get Hill a 3-point play off a staggered double screen by the two bigs.
Staggered double screen, what's that mean?
That's when the 5-man, the center, and the 4-man, 2 big players go down and screen a double screen on a shooter.
All right, we'll watch for it. There's Hill for 3. And Agagne battles the teammate Anderson for the rebound. And Sondeleiter comes out with it. And a hold is spotted.
Well, they actually ran the other play. It was a flare double screen, Larry, by the 5 and 4 men. Not a down screen. They flared him out for the shooter. They ran him off the flare.
Sondeleiter, foul number 3 for Iowa. He thought he'd cleanly picked the pocket of Anagagne, but he hooked him prior to getting the ball.
Only the second team foul this half, however.
Greg Bruner into the Iowa lineup, replacing Sondeleiter. So Iowa's two biggest players, Reiner and Sondeleiter, each with 3 fouls. Corbett against Bruner. Corbett's had a good ball game today. 8 points for Michigan State.
Here's the weave. Iowa switching the weave on the perimeter. 3-man weave around Anagagne at the high post.
Anderson with a good look. Alvin Anderson knocks it down. His 7th point. Comes in averaging 10.
The Michigan State guards have excellent size. They're 6'3", 6'4". They can drive the ball into the lane and jump up over the smaller Hawkeye guards and get good shots.
Michigan State keeps making runs at Iowa, but the Hawkeyes have held them off so far, and there's a foul call on Andreas for Michigan State.
Now that's the 6th on Michigan State. Iowa will be shooting the 1-1 from here on out. Michigan State must play without fouling. If I always wanted my team to get fouled, get to the foul line is high percentage offense.
Especially the way Michigan State normally shoots them, but today they are just 5 of 10 from the free throw line. Neither team's been to the line here in the second half.
Matchup zone. Every time a Hawkeye player catches it, a Michigan State player will be head up just like man-to-man.
The deflection by Anagagne, but something else was spotted inside first, and it was a foul on Michigan State.
And the Hawkeyes do go to the foul line. This bodes well for Iowa and puts Michigan State in a problem, especially down the stretch if they're trying to come from behind, because Iowa will be shooting fouls.
Next time, that was foul number 6, so the next one will be the 7th. Leslie, Horner, Worley, Bruner, and Reiner, the starters, now in for Iowa.
Michigan State knows where Horner is at all times.
There's Leslie for 3. Rebound by Reiner, taken away by Anagagne. They drill a tie ball, and it's an Iowa ball according to the possession arrow.
Larry, I think it's a foul on Hill. I think they got a foul on Hill, and Iowa will now go to the foul line.
You're right. Now, one official called the jump ball, called the tie ball, but the other official ruled the foul on Hill, and it's number 3. And number 7 on Michigan State.
Well, Reiner doesn't shoot the ball a lot, but he is a 76% foul shooter. Very good for a tall player. Excellent free throw shooter.
Has not scored today, but what an outstanding junior year so far. Last year averaged 3 points, 2.5 rebounds. This year, 8 points and 9.5 rebounds, which is 2nd best in the Big Ten. And he sinks his first point of the afternoon.
Well, with the graduation of Recker and Evans, if you want to continue to be good, your players who did not play a lot or score a lot the year before must step their game up, and this young man has gotten a lot better this year.
And Steve Alford said all along last year that Evans took up so much space in the middle. He said when he's gone, Reiner and Worley will be better players because they'll have more opportunities. They've taken advantage of it. It's a 5-point Iowa lead as Michigan State comes down with 8.5 to play. The pull-up by Lorbeck. The rebound is grabbed by Bruner.
Again, I don't think that's the shot Coach Izzo wants. The outside jump shot by a 6'10 player.
And 6 rebounds by the very tough freshman from Charles City, Iowa, Greg Bruner.
And Anagagne now on Worley. Has quicker feet defensively. Should be able to guard Worley on the perimeter.
Here's Worley, still on fire. 27 for Glenn Worley.
Excellent screen by Bruner. Bruner sets the screen and Worley flares out and banks home another 3.
Worley having the best game of his career against a team that tried to recruit him.
And a team that's very tough on the defensive end of the court as well.
Corbett goes in deep, foul call first prior to the shot. And it's whistled against Greg Bruner, his 2nd foul. The Hawkeyes with just their 3rd team foul, while Michigan State is already in the penalty. Well, Glenn Worley, the 6'7 junior from Iowa City, has had an incredible ball game, including 4 3-pointers. He's given Iowa an 8-point lead. That's Iowa 57 and 20th ranked Michigan State 49, 7:41 left to play in Iowa City. Behind the Michigan State bench, a guy who was a terrific baseball player for the Spartans and later Steve Garvey.
Well, a great baseball player. I would love his autograph, but if you see Brad Banks in the house, my son Ben at home, who's a 10-year-old, would love to have Brad Banks' autograph. Great year for Iowa football.
Yes, it certainly was. Between Steve Garvey and Kirk Gibson, two great players from Michigan State's baseball past.
Absolutely.
And Aganye, Ager, Torbert, Hill, and Lorbeck in the lineup for Amika Davis in the lineup for Michigan State as they inbound the basketball. Iowa counters with Bruner, Leslie, Worley, Sondeliner, and Boyd.
And Paul Davis back in the lineup after a rest.
Davis has had a tough time getting on track today. But he's a freshman with great potential. Hill for another three. That is the fifth three of the ball game for Chris Hill.
Simple read. He handed it off, and the Iowa defense got behind the handoff man, behind the screen, and he bangs home another three.
Hill held the 4 points by Ohio State. He obviously came out on a mission today. Trying to add to a 5-point lead as we go inside 7 minutes. Worley with another look and a rare miss for him today. Bruner with an offensive rebound. Takes it up in a crowd and Ager clears it for Michigan State. Hill finds Davis. The rebound out of bounds. Last touch by Iowa.
Paul Davis struggling. He's going to be an excellent player. Just can't seem to get it all together here today. Hill has taken 132 shots this year, of which 90 are from three. If you are Iowa, you must make Hill put the ball down on the floor. No standstill threes. He shoots the ball too well.
Hill, 66 threes as a freshman, already 40 coming in, and 5 more today in his sophomore year. And we have a push spotted on the inbounds. Worley called on the holdout, his second foul. The Hawkeyes as a team with 4, Michigan State at 7. And Anagagne will inbound in just a moment.
The referee's doing a good job trying to keep this game under control. Both teams want this game very, very badly. And they're going to put it all on the line here to see if they can get their team a win, each player.
Steve Skiles stepping up and making sure that everything is cool. Hill for yet another three. Not this time. Torbert and Bruner battle for the rebound. And a tie ball, and it's Iowa on the alternating possession. Or did they rule a foul on Torbert? Oh, they got Torbert with a foul.
Foul over the... Excellent look. Another screen-to-screener play. Hill gets maybe the best look he's had all day, but can't make it. And Torbert goes over the back for the offensive foul.
That kind of daylight, you're ready to mark it down for three for Hill, aren't you?
I was about to count it.
So at the line, Bruner on the 18th foul by Michigan State. Bruner from the free throw line this year, a 53% shooter. 4 points today for Greg Bruner. Now let's take a moment to thank our Big Ten corporate sponsor, Gatorade Thirst Quencher. It's in college basketball. Is it in you? Gatorade.
Greg Bruner has been a big surprise for Steve Alford and his staff. He's very competitive, smart, knows how to play.
Has 8 rebounds today. Sondeliner tries to tip it back, but tips it out of bounds, and so it's Michigan State ball. 6.5 to go in a 6-point Spartan deficit. Iowa's free throw shooting been a problem over the last couple of ball games, and in the second half, it's only 50%, 2 out of 4. Davis to the right. First basket, but a big one.
Excuse me, Larry. Excellent pass back across the court by Hill. He was going right, and he crossed it back to the left side, and Davis laid it in the basket.
Worley against Anagagne. It's been a good matchup today. Worley spins in. Going high to pull down the rebound is Sondeleiter. Now Bruner comes up with it. And counts the basket. The Hawkeyes are really after it, especially on the offensive glass today. And there's been no stopping Glenn Worley.
Keeping it alive on the offensive board. Bruner first. He can't get it up. He passes it to Worley. He gets it up and gets fouled. Offensive rebounding can create a lot of opportunities. Instead of Michigan State having it down four, they very easily can have it down seven.
Worley with a chance at a 30th point, missing the free throw. 29 for Glenn Worley, a six-point lead for Iowa.
Michigan State needs to have poise and patience to get the shot it wants, not the shot the Iowa defense wants.
Anderson finds Davis, who is calling for the ball. Davis starts to drive, and Worley fouls it. For Worley, his third foul. And for the Hawkeyes, it's their fifth. So Michigan State still a couple away from the bonus with 5.5 to go. This has truly been a hard-fought Big Ten game, typical of the Spartan-Hawkeye rivalry.
I've enjoyed it very much as a Southeastern Conference ACC area coach. This has been a war here in the Big Ten.
Ager for three, right there.
My.
14 for Maurice Ager, coming off a 15-point game against Ohio State. What a week for the Spartan freshman.
That was a big-time jump-up three-point shot.
And it's a three-point game. Sondeleiter trying to get inside Davis. Now Horner handling it against Hill. And the battle inside there between Bruner and Anagande. From outside, it's Leslie. Davis and Worley crash the boards. And it's Davis on the foul. Maurice Ager has been an outstanding freshman so far for Michigan State.
Gets an excellent screen by Anagunwe and just jumps up and bangs home a three. Very difficult shot coming off the screen outside from the baseline area.
Glenn Worley now trying to become the first Iowa player to get the 30 points since Luke Recker did it December of 2001 against Missouri. And that's twice now. He's had a free throw to get number 30 and they would not go down. Ballinger in, Anagunwe out. Reiner in, Sondeleiter out for Iowa. Look at these numbers for Glenn Worley. A career day for Glenn Worley.
Incredible, and he's done it inside and outside and also on the board. He misses two, however.
And now he's missed three free throws in a row, missing two there. He missed two in the final minute at Northwestern.
Every decision now is crucial. Every pass, every shot's got to be a good one.
Michigan State, three timeouts remaining. Iowa with four timeouts remaining.
And Horner doing a great job keeping the ball out of Ager's hands.
Shot clock winds down. Ballinger tries to get it inside to Davis. The Hawkeyes take it away.
Now Ballinger could have shot that from three, decided to go inside. Most big guys turn the ball over more than guards.
Timeout, Iowa, with 3:56 to play, a 30-second timeout. Iowa with a three-point lead at 60-57. Michigan State trying to prolong a six-game Big Ten winning streak, dating back to the last five games of last year. Earlier today in the Big Ten, it was Northwestern going to Purdue and the Boilermakers coming up with a victory. Willie Dean with a big game. And Michigan at Penn State. Michigan suddenly on a roll, Eddie.
What a win over Wisconsin the other night. Incredible.
And Connecticut pulls off a close win. Oklahoma is getting underway at home against Colorado. They're a team that has handed Michigan State one of their four losses this year.
And there's a big one in the Southeastern Conference. I think Georgia's the best team in that league.
Kansas with a big win over Nebraska and Maryland. Knocking off Florida State. 17th ranked Terps roll on. Louisville's playing some good basketball, aren't they?
Great.
And coming up immediately following this game, it's Wisconsin at number 11, Illinois.
Well, Iowa will look to get to the foul line. They're shooting two free throws the rest of the way out. Come on,
clock at 10. Worley trying to break down Anderson. They played against each other in a high school game one time. Bruner hit in the head as he loses the basketball. The officials will take a timeout to attend to Greg Bruner. Worley played at Iowa City West, and one time Anderson's Minnesota De La Salle High School team played, so they played against each other before. But right now the Iowa concern is the health of Bruner, who got a shot in the head. John Streep, the veteran Iowa trainer, comes out to take a look at him, and while he does, and while he is helped up, and he's a tough young guy, and no doubt he'll hang around. Dr. Dave Johnson, the Iowa team position there to inspect. It looked like maybe the forehead is just above the eyes where he landed, the elbow landed.
And certainly inadvertent, no intentional hit by any means. He was out of control trying to take the ball to the basket.
And so we have an official's timeout. 3:33 left in a tight ball game in Iowa City.
Today's Big Ten game has been brought to you by GMC. From professional-grade people come professional-grade trucks. And by Cooper Tire. Proud to be the official tire of the Big Ten Conference. Cooper Tire. Don't give up a thing.
As it often does when these two teams play, it's down to the wire. Kayla Alford, the daughter of Steve Alford, clutching her doll tight. Mom Tanya taking care of Kayla's hair. They're excited. They're on the edge of their seat, and why not? It's a thriller. Iowa with a three-point lead over Michigan State. Our game reset, Eddie. As Steve Alford, his dad, Sam, look in from the Hawkeye bench. It's a three-point Iowa lead.
And Iowa has a foul to give, Larry. A foul to give. Anytime if Michigan State gets the ball inside, I would give up the foul before I give up the easy basket.
Iowa with the possession arrow. Both coaches the same number of timeouts. Ballinger makes a tough catch on the baseline. Ballinger has it taken away by Reiner. Jared Reiner springing out to steal the pass. Iowa with the ball and a three-point lead at the three-minute mark.
Let's see where Iowa goes to get a shot. With Luke Recker graduating and Evans graduating, Leslie looks like to be the man. When the clock runs down, I think the ball will be in Leslie's hands.
And they usually like him to start from the top in that situation.
Low 1-4, and he likes to drive the ball right. Michigan State, straight man-to-man.
Leslie for three. And it's an air ball, and the ball goes to Michigan State with 2:39 remaining. Now, bear in mind, the Spartans have led only once. That was 6-4 at the 17-minute mark. But they're now a three away from tying the ball game.
Well, a lot of time left in this game. As you mentioned, both teams have timeouts left. Three. Iowa has a foul to give. Michigan State is giving up the double bonus if they foul. But plenty of time left. If I'm Michigan State, I'm trying to get the ball inside and pound it to the big people, get on the offensive board, or shoot the wide open three.
Hill, Torbert, Ager, and Aganye, and Anderson on the floor right now for Michigan State. Tipped by Leslie, blocked by Leslie. Big scramble. And what is the rule? Michigan State got it and got a timeout, I believe. Or they called a timeout. Did they get it?
Yes, they did.
Heads up play by Michigan State. Eddie, I know from all your 30 years in coaching, you admire effort. We're seeing a load of effort on both sides today.
Larry, I've seen a number of games this year. This is the most intense game I've seen all year. Hill takes an ill-advised shot. He gets it blocked. The ball gets on the floor. This is a huge possession in this game. And they get on the floor, and Anderson gets it, and good call. He had the ball in his hands for a timeout.
And then he got the timeout, so it saved a Michigan State possession. Now, coming up immediately following our ball game today, the explosive Wisconsin Badgers have a tough road test. They take on the 11th-ranked Fighting Illini in Champaign. This is a game you're not going to want to miss, only from ESPN Plus, Wisconsin and Illinois, coming up next. You take a look at the Badgers, and certainly they have had some outstanding play. Kirk Penny averaging 16 points a game. Devin Harris averaging 15 points a game. Pretty tough duo to stop.
Absolutely. And Bo Ryan's done a great job up there in Madison. You must watch the excellent set plays out of bounds underneath with your Iowa.
15 seconds for the Spartans to shoot, but Hill will shoot right there. Wow. Six threes for Chris Hill.
And there's the set play for Hill to shoot the three. Ball game's tied.
There's the guy you want to have on your squad with the ball in his hands in that situation. Man, is he a shooter. 2 minutes to play in a tie ball game.
Anderson and Sondalata really going after it.
Torbert on the takeaway, and Horner fouls him, and Torbert almost got the roll.
Out of bounds underneath. I believe you should play zone there. Great plays versus the man-to-man. Hill gets the down screen for the shot by Tarbert, but he was the guy who took the ball out of bounds as well. He took it out, set a screen, got a screen, and knocked home the three.
Kelvin Torbert, a 77% free throw shooter. An 8-point day for Torbert, and a miss. And Michigan State, that's their first free throw of the second half, and they missed it for the game. They are 5 of 11 after going 29 of 30 on Thursday. How do you explain that?
It's called coaching, and you have no control over for the most part. We got Brody in the game now, who's an excellent shooter. Again, Iowa shooting the double bonus. Michigan State must play without fouling.
This is for the Spartan lead. Michigan State has their first lead since the game was 3 minutes old. It comes with a minute 49 to play. Horner, Worley, Boyd, Reiner, and Leslie on the court for Iowa.
Michigan State switching on the perimeter, trying to make Horner and Brody drivers.
Horner takes it to the lane and gets fouled on the way in. So Jeff Horner will go to the line. He's an 81% free throw shooter, 17 out of 21, and one of those guys who wants the ball in this situation with the game on the line. The foul call on Timbo Grackus.
Well, he's a winner. He's a tough kid, as is Brody Boyd. They're both excellent shooters and tough-nosed competitors.
And again, Michigan State struggling at the line today, but so are the Hawkeyes. Horner ties it at 61.
A lot of time left in this game. 131. Again, both teams have timeouts to use. Next jump ball favors Iowa.
Look at the shiner on Greg Bruner's right eye. My goodness, he got an elbow squarely on that eye. Bruner icing it down. He's a tough kid, though. You know he wants to get back in. Ballinger in for Tom Izzo, replacing Torbert. Horner to give Iowa the lead if he hits. And both teams, whoever loses this one's going to look at some free throw shooting down the stretch and hang their head.
And both excellent foul shooting teams coming in.
Anderson out front for Michigan State. Ballinger to the baseline.
Let's see where Michigan State goes as the clock winds down without Marcus Taylor on their team this year.
Hager has had the hot hand, but he loses it to Brody Boyd. The Hawkeyes have the numbers. Boyd in against Hill. Hill tries to take it away and sends Boyd to the line.
Excellent hesitation dribble by Brody Boyd. He got Hill up in the air. Hager gets the ball tapped away. Boyd comes out with it, and he gets a little hesitation dribble and goes by and gets fouled.
Now, I don't know how well Chris Hill has studied the stat sheet. He's a very bright guy, but if he had studied it well, he'd know Brody Boyd is a good guy for him to foul. Boyd, 10 of 18 from the foul line this season.
But there's a young man that has excellent form, Larry. Tremendous follow through, great rotation on his free throw. He will shoot much higher than the 55% by the end of the year.
He gives Iowa the lead with 57.8 left in regulation. So Boyd knocks down two clutch free throws. The crowd's on their feet here in Iowa City. And Tom Izzo will talk to his basketball team and burn a timeout. You see the timeouts remaining. Izzo's down to his last one.
Well, Larry, coming up next, of course, the Fighting Illini of Illinois at home in Assembly Hall. It's Illinois, Wisconsin, two of four teams to share last year's Big Ten crown. That's the third of today's Big Ten triple header. We'll get you out to Assembly Hall right after the Michigan State-Iowa game. Let's go back to Iowa City.
And coming up next, that'll be a great one between Wisconsin and Illinois. Couldn't be any better than this one, though.
This is a great basketball game, Larry. I look for Michigan State to run a quick hitting set play. They've got a number of them from the side out of bounds right in front of their bench. And if they can get up a good quick look, they will guarantee themselves to get the ball back at least one more time. Coaches call this trying to play two possessions for one possession that Iowa would have. Two for one. Let's see if they can get up a good quick look.
Okay, here's our game reset with Iowa leading by two. Michigan State, one timeout remaining. Iowa with three. to see the team foul situation, and Iowa has the possession arrow.
If they can't get a quick look, they got to have patience because they need a great shot, but they're going to try to get a quick one here. And they can't.
Anderson inbounds.
Now they need to wait for a great look at the basket, and then they need to pound the offensive board.
Joe trying to break down Leslie. Reiner's out to help. Ballinger takes a three. Ballinger runs down the rebound, takes another. Anderson is there, and Anderson is fouled. Anderson with the rebound. Michigan State cracking the offensive glass for a third try at it.
Two excellent looks by Ballinger. He could have made either of those shots, but then again, you must pound the offensive board. And again, the size of Michigan State. Anderson, 6'6 guard. Huge.
Tom Izzo is still looking for a leader for this team. He thinks this young man, Allen Anderson, only a sophomore, has great leadership potential. Right now, he needs two free throws to tie the ball game. Michigan State, 26 consecutive free throws on Thursday night, but really struggling at the line tonight, and Anderson's going to have a while to think about the next one because the Hawkeyes use a timeout.
Well, 33.9 left. Iowa can hold this ball for the rest of the game. If Michigan State makes this free throw, I look for them to come out in a press trying to get a 5-second count or perhaps a steal. If not, they're then going to have to pick someone to foul and put Iowa on the foul line. Iowa is in the double bonus, however. They will shoot two free throws. I look for Coach Alford to take a timeout if he cannot get the ball inbounds and have his best free throw shooters on the court and certainly put the ball in the best free throw shooters' hands so they can get him to the foul line.
All coming up right after this one. Two of the defending champions of the four defending champions in the Big Ten from last year. Wisconsin coming off that tough loss at Michigan. At home or on the road at number 11, Illinois, the Fighting Illini, 11-1 coming into that ballgame. Take a look at the all-time championship list as Wisconsin and Illinois get ready to battle. They are on that list, but Purdue leads it.
Now, I would not have guessed Purdue. I would have guessed Indiana.
A lot of great basketball in one state, though. A lot of Big Ten championships right there. Anderson tries to pull his team within one. Rebound to Reiner. And the Hawkeyes will see Reiner go to the line as Anderson and Anagagne all over him to foul him immediately. It's Anagagne with the foul, and for Aloysius, that's number four.
Good foul, although Reiner's a 76% free throw shooter. I believe he's missed his last three. If he makes just one of the two, Michigan State will be one possession behind with a three-point attempt to tie this game up. Yet there's a lot of time left. They don't need a three. They ought to get a good two and call timeout if they can.
Reiner at one time above 80%, but just 2 of 5 at Northwestern, 1 of 2 today. But under pressure, he sinks it. That's why college basketball is so great. Here you got two guys struggling at the line. Brody Boyd knocks them both down. Reiner struggled at the line. He hits a clutch free throw. It's a three-point game, and now he's got a chance to make it a two-possession game.
Well, either way, whether it's a 3 or 4 point game, Michigan State has enough time to go for a good, quick two, score, and timeout.
And it is now a two-possession game, a four-point Iowa lead. The Hawkeyes trying to knock off a rated team here in Iowa City for the first time since they beat 7th-ranked Illinois here 2 years ago. They celebrate the 20th anniversary of Carver Hawkeye Arena against the team that ruined the opener. That was Michigan State winning the first game ever in this building.
Very interesting, and it's my first time to this wonderful facility and building. What a great environment for college basketball here in Iowa City, Iowa.
So now both coaches are down to one timeout with 31 and a half seconds remaining.
Well, again, Michigan State needs a good shot, or they need to get to the foul line. They need to have it happen quickly. If they score, they need to call a quick timeout and use their last timeout to set their defense. If they miss a shot, they must foul the rebounder right away, regardless of who gets the rebound.
Up next from Champaign, the Badgers and the 11th-ranked Illini. That's immediately following this game. Glenn Worley, 29 points, a career best for him. He leads the Iowa crowd. The game reset. Again, one timeout, a 60 for both coaches. And the possession arrow favors
Double
Iowa.
High post screen.
Barnes have to score and score in a hurry.
And defended well by Iowa.
Corbett loses it. What did they call? They called the jump ball. Iowa got the arrow.
Larry, to start this game, Iowa got the jump ball. At the half, it went back to Michigan State because Iowa controlled the opening jump ball. They get the next possession, and that's why it's their ball. They had the opening tip. That's why the opening tip can be a big play in college basketball.
Absolutely right. Bograkis in defensively for Michigan State. Iowa with the ball, a four-point lead, and you see how much time remains. The shot clock is off. And we have a hold on Michigan State. A foul called on Allen Anderson, his third foul.
Well, Horner, an 81% free throw shooter, and my guess would be in games like this down the stretch, maybe 90%. The bigger the shots, the tougher this young man is.
Last year's Iowa Mr. Basketball.
If I'm Coach Alford now, I am looking to play something, Larry, when I coach, called three-point defense. I would switch every perimeter screen to make sure we would cover the shooters on the perimeter, particularly if he makes this shot. It would be a six-point lead, two-possession game with 17 seconds to go.
And, of course, Tom Izzo has his three-point shooters in there.
Boy, do I love Jeff Horner. The Hawkeye fans have a treat for the next couple years watching this young man just get better, better, and better.
Absolutely. Horner makes it a six-point game, so the Spartans need a pair of threes. And now the official timer calls the official score over. The official score, this is Tom Izzo joins the conversation. They're wanting to get, we talked about good three-point shooters, and I wonder where Chris Hill is. They want to get him into the game, and now in this final minute, they're questioning the strategy and the rules to get him in.
So he should go, no.
He has to sit out. He has to sit out one possession by rule.
Tim Hutchinson over there to talk to Hill. Again, Hill's the best three-point shooter in the building, and Tom Izzo wants him in there, and he's not in there right now. Again, it's the Badgers of the Fighting Illini up next from Champaign, Wisconsin, coming off a game where they saw a large lead evaporate late in Michigan, winning at the buzzer. Illinois on a roll off to an 11-1 start. The Illini come into that ball game with a 8-game Big Ten winning streak.
Hill must sit out one possession. The clock must run. He went out by the free throws were taken. No time went off the clock. He cannot come in the game. I look for Iowa to switch every screen. No three-point attempts, no fouls.
Anderson off the pick.
Here's
by Antegagne. Ballinger for three behind the Antegagne screen.
Timeout.
Just as Eddie Fogler called it, the Spartans have made it a three-point game. They will use their last timeout, a full timeout, to set up the full court.
Well, here's the ball screen. Reiner helps out, but he doesn't get back to Ballinger as Leslie continued to go with Anderson, and he gets the open look three, last timeout. Again, the ball screen and screen down for the shooter, and Ballinger bangs home a big three. Nice screen by Antegagne.
Hey, how about the confidence of Adam Ballinger, who has struggled? He took a couple of threes a moment ago, didn't make them, but he had the confidence to stick that one.
Big, big shot.
He came in 5 out of 16 from threes. He's a good player who struggled in his senior year, but he stepped up when the Spartans needed him to.
Michigan State now will press full court, Larry. They will try to make the following happen. They would love to get a 5-second count. If not, they would love to steal the inbounds pass. If not, they must foul right away. Coach Alford, on the other hand, will have a very good ball handler taking it out. Interestingly to note, he can run the baseline. That is a huge advantage because a basket was just scored. He will try to get the ball into a good foul shooter's hands because they're going to foul him right away if they get in. If he can't get the ball in, they will use their last timeout. That's why coaches save their timeouts for situations just like this.
As soon as we get done here, it's Wisconsin at Illinois. Bill Self's team playing extremely well. The Badgers trying to contain Brian Cook, the Big Ten's leading scorer. the instant foul as Horner, the man that Iowa wanted to get the ball, did. Anderson wraps around it.
Well, you saw Reiner run the baseline to use that advantage, and he gets it into the man they want on the foul line, Jeff Horner. Nice setup by Coach Alford at the timeout.
What a terrific basketball game today, Eddie.
This is great. Except I just feel sorry for the losing coach
because
I was there too much of my career.
I do too.
And Tom Izzo's team, who's played from behind most of the day, will have to look back at their glowing statistic from the other day, free throw shooting. Horner has hit three in a row in the final minute, and he's made it a two-possession game once again. Now Chris Hill into the lineup for Michigan State, but now it takes more than a three for the Spartans.
Well, Michigan State can only take it out, throw it long, try to hit one. The clock does stop in the last minute and maybe foul somebody right away or steal it. Long shots, however.
Corner of the miss there. The Spartans won't have much defensive pressure. Ager for three. Ballinger tries to follow, and it's all over in Iowa City. And for the first time in 2 years, the Hawkeyes have knocked off a rated team on their home floor as Iowa beats Michigan State 68-64. For Eddie Folger, I'm Larry Morgan. Now we go to Champaign, Illinois for Wisconsin at Illinois. Let's join Wayne Larrabee and Bob Ford.